Hello guys, and welcome back to the channel. So you're probably coming across this video because maybe you want to travel to Poland, be it to work or as a tourist or to study. Or maybe you know someone who wants to come and study in Poland. So this video is for you. So in this video, I'm going to discuss with you three of the most important visas that you may need to know, and this will help you know which kind of visa you might want to apply for. So to begin with, we're going to talk about the Schengen visa, and this visa is mainly for short-term stays right in the Schengen 21 Schengen countries. So let's say you want to travel to Poland to visit family, or you're just a tourist, you just want to move around and see, take pictures, visit beautiful places, or for whatever reason that you want to come. It might be even a business trip, right? As long as it's for short-term stay, you will need to get this Schengen visa. It's more suitable for you if you just want to come for a short term, right? And it is one specific thing. You are only allowed to be in the Schengen area for a period of 90 days within a 180-day period. I don't know if it makes sense, right? I compiled it. Let me just read it out to you, right? It says, this visa allows you to stay in Poland and other Schengen countries for up to 90 days within a 180-day period, right? So as you can see, it's just a short-term stay. This is the Schengen visa. Now, there's also a work visa. Now, you might need to listen much more carefully on this one. So, for a work visa, obviously, you are planning to come to Poland to work, right? So, what you will need is you will need an offer from your employer. So, you will need to look for the job before you travel to Poland. And when you get the job, you get the contracts signed. You compile all your documents, your offer, your contract, and your company has to apply for a work permit for you. So this work permit also has to be attached on your visa application, right? So you will need a work permit to get a work visa. So a work visa and a work permit are two separate documents, right? A work permit allows you to work in Poland, and a work visa makes you legal to stay in Poland, right? So these two documents are for two different things, right? A visa, work visa, allows you to stay legally in Poland, and a work permit allows you to work in Poland, right? And then lastly, the other document, the other type of visa, is obviously the student visa. I traveled to Poland with a student visa, right? So a student visa obviously is for you if you want to come and study in Poland, right? So for your student visa, obviously you will need to first get admitted at any university or school that you applied to. They will give you a conditional offer letter. This conditional offer letter, from the name of course, it has a list of conditions that you have to meet for them to give you an acceptance letter. An acceptance letter is the one that is required by the embassy. So you need to attach your acceptance letter to your application, right? Your visa application, right? So as I said, on the work visa, you will need a work permit. But if you come as a student and then you manage to graduate from a Polish university, your degree certificate, your diploma certificate will work as a work permit for you. So you will no longer need a work permit, but you use that as a work permit. So you use it to apply for a residency card in Poland. I don't know if it makes sense. So if you came as a worker with a work visa, when you want to extend your stay, you will need a work permit. But if you came as a student after your graduation, you will not need a work permit. You will need to provide the proof that you graduated from a Polish school, and then obviously your job contract if you have already found a job. So these are the three important visas that I think you might need to know if you're considering traveling to Poland or any other European country, right? So this was it for the video. If you found the information useful, please like the video, share and subscribe, and also put comments down below if you think that I might have missed something. So until then, take care.